So Noah went from a man, a regular man that was known in the community, to saving the whole world. Build me an ark. That's what God told Noah. So when I talk about evangelism here, I want you to know that as an evangelist, you're not a small person. As an evangelist, you are massive in the eyes of God. When God looks into the world, the first people he looks for are his ambassadors. And so think about this here. You've gone from saying to your friend, I don't have a job. You've gone from saying to your friend, oh, I don't have money. You've gone from saying to your friend, I want to travel, but I don't have money. Everything goes back to money. You go from saying things like, I don't have clothes. I wish I could buy that house. But God is saying to you now that evangelism is a divine job. You're not thinking like a human being no more. Just like God said to Noah, build me an ark and save the whole world. When you become an evangelist, God is saying to you, wake up, Newton, and witness to the whole world. I had it in the definition I gave you about evangelism. It wasn't from the dictionary. God gave me a revelation, and he told me the divine definition of evangelism is, it's a divine job. It's a divine job. Say divine job again.
Divine job.
It's a divine job or an exercise of going out publicly and communicating and teaching. See, you become a teacher now. You've gone from not having a job. You've gone from being homeless. You've gone from being useless. You've gone from being disappointed to becoming a teacher. Or educated. You've become an educator. That's what God has done for you. Or interacting, or delivering the word of God to every human being in the world. Wow! So you've gone from this small woman, you've gone from this minute man, to speaking to the world. Oh! Now, they don't call you Newton no more, they call you Evangelist Newton. Right, you're delivering the message to the whole world now. You're telling them about Jesus. Jesus has died in the flesh. Jesus can't come and speak to the whole world in the spirit. We can't see him. So you've become, as an evangelist, the Jesus they can see. Say, I am the Jesus they can see.
I am the Jesus they can see.
Say, I am the Jesus they can see.
I am the Jesus they can see.
Say, as an evangelist, I witness to the whole world.
As an evangelist, I witness to the whole world.
Say, I don't hide no more.
I don't hide no more.
Say,
actually,
I give the world life.
I communicate to the whole world.
So now you don't have to go to the job center no more. And say to the man, oh, I've been waiting for 2 weeks here. Oh, the government, they hate me so much. A man of God don't talk like that. Can you imagine Jesus Christ coming to preach to the multitude of 5,000 people? And the first thing you say to them is, the people, they don't have no hope. They're looking for someone to lift them up. And Jesus Christ comes and says to them, you know what? I went to the job center the other day here. That before I got that vacancy, someone else took it. They will say to him, you're not the Son of God.
Right.
So as an evangelist, God will prepare you for the battle that lies ahead. It's a divine job. It's a spiritual job. You're changing lives. We've done the role play today. You know what? If you've done the role play today, can I see your hand? If you've done the role play today, can I see your hand? No, lift it up, lift it up. If you've done the role play today, can I see your hand up? So wave and say, I'm an evangelist. Say, I will do an evangelist work. No, so wave like you mean it, because we've done the work. You're not trying to lift up your hand. Wave, say, I'm an evangelist. And I will do an evangelist work. I have to do an evangelist's work. This is what it's all about. Because you know what, yeah? My sister's a problem. Life is not about coming to the divine rescue and just eating and going home. That's not enough. Hello, pay attention. If we just come to And we walk away like that. We're not doing God any justice, Peter. Oh my God. God wants you to witness to the whole world, and you're here complaining about little things. That is a waste. You're an evangelist. Now, as an evangelist, you wake up in the morning, you dress up like Pastor Jimba Alex, but you don't have to cut your trousers like I did. You dress up like Pastor Jimba Alex, you wear a nice suit, you boost your personality, and you walk on the street. You say, I'm an evangelist. See that? People say, Henry's walking differently these days. I'm an evangelist. Newton is walking different these days. I'm an evangelist. You say, I used to go to Elephant and Castle. I've won all the souls in Elephant and Castle. Tomorrow, I'm going to Manchester. People will say, the way Henry is walking has changed, you know. What if Henry win the lottery? You don't even have the money in your pocket, but your faith is so high. You say, I'm an evangelist. I speak to the whole world. I'm going to Manchester to go and do a job for God. Hallelujah. We are the sons of God. Say amen. We are the sons of God. Stop belittling yourself. Olanike said something today. He said, she gave a big testimony. She said, I'm starting work in social care. That's a good thing. But only a human being can give you that job. God does not move because you're starting a job in social care. If God made you an evangelist, God can say to you, go and speak to the president or prime minister of Canada tomorrow. What are you going to do?
I can't help
them. So what I'm trying to say, Moses in the Bible didn't have a title. Hello. Moses in the Bible didn't have a physical title. So he wasn't known as Pastor Moses or Evangelist Moses. But spiritually, Moses was a leader. He was a man of God. He was a pastor. How about he was a pastor? He was an evangelist. Because that's how he was speaking to the congregation, the children of Israel, in their thousands. He was born again. Look at the Natalia. She's speaking. I know what she's speaking. But God is with you also. So I want to talk about evangelism today. You have to communicate with the whole world. And not only do you have to communicate with the whole world, you have to tell them about Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lift up your hands, I will tell them about Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Say, I will tell them about Jesus. Say, I will tell them about Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Say, they have to know about Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lift up your hands, say, they have to know about Jesus Christ of Nazareth. They have to know, I will speak to them about Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Say, I don't need a man to employ me. Say, I have a divine job from God. I'm an evangelist. Newton, wave your DVD. Wave your DVD. Say, I'm an evangelist. Hallelujah. I'm an evangelist of God. Hallelujah. And no one can change it. Tell the people about the Almighty God also. Say, I will tell them about the Almighty God. You know, Newton, or my congregation here, yeah? If you are the mansion, yeah? Or if you're the chairman of a great global organization, and nobody talks about it. Nobody comes to visit you in your house. You're just there by yourself. Nobody comes to your organization. You will be such a lonely man, do you know that? Right. So in a way, God is no different as well. God has made us pastors and evangelists to advertise his name. He gets something from it. He gets a boost. He said, look, the devil wanted to take Henry, but now Henry's telling the people about me. He will do something for you also. You got this big old organization, great name, this and that, 40 acres of land, 500 rooms, 15 limousines, and in the morning you're just sitting there by yourself. No one to talk to. What kind of rich man is this? You're a sad man. That's what you are. But until they put you on TV, and it flashes, hey, this organization is in Los Angeles, and it goes all over the world, and people are liking it, people are calling it. You're giving the organization life. You have to lift up the name of God. God has called you. No one in my church Listen to this again. No one in gospel faith ministries complains. Say, I will never complain.
I'll never complain.
Say, I don't complain.
I'll not complain.
Say, I don't complain. Say, I will never complain. You don't come here and complain. Because if you're complaining, it means that Jesus Christ is not alive. Why did Jesus Christ arise from the dead? He arose from the dead to give you a resurrection life and to give you peace and joy unspeakable. You're not going to come to my church. You're not going to come to my church and say, I'm complaining. We don't do things like that. Say, I'm not going to complain. Say, I'm going to praise the Lord.
I'm going to pray for
the Lord. Say, I'm going to praise the Lord.
I'm going to praise the Lord.
Now that God has made you an evangelist, one more thing you have to do. If you got notes, write this thing down. Write this thing down. Write this thing down. This is important. One more thing you have to do is you have to bring people to the church of God. You just don't wake up in the morning and say, my name is Ruth. I'm going to the church. No, 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 no. That is selfish. You just don't wake up in the morning, you say, my name is Newton. And you come and sit in the church all by yourself. And you take it whilst your friends are out there doing whatever it is they do. That's not the way of God. Say, I'll bring people to the church. Say, I will bring as much as I can to the church of God. Say, God has made me an evangelist for a reason. No, be a witness. Lift up your hand. Say, God has made me an evangelist. Wave to the heaven. God has made me an evangelist for a reason. Wave to the heaven. Say, God has made me an evangelist for a reason. God has made me an evangelist for a reason. God has made me an evangelist for a reason. Hallelujah. God has made me an evangelist for a reason. Hallelujah. What I want you to do, hello, what I want you to do right now is, Latoya, you're a witness. Come and get this. These are leaflets for the Gospel Faith Ministry Church. Say, I'm an evangelist.
I'm an evangelist.
Newton. Come and get yours, brother. God will strengthen you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Now you've got a job to do for God. Newton, listen, from giving these leaflets out, as small as they are, you will speak to the world. Hallelujah. It starts from here. There's anointing in my church. Henry, come and get yours, please. Hallelujah. There's so much anointing in the place. So much anointing. Say, I'm an evangelist of God. Say, I will give them out. I will invite them to the church. Kevin, come and get yours, sir. Hallelujah. Say, I'm an evangelist of God. Say, God has given me something to do.
God has given me something to do.
Say, I've got a divine job. I have a divine job.
I have a divine job.
Amen. Or like you can. Come and get yours for me. I am blessed. I belong to Jesus. I belong to... How many do you want? Say what you want to say. I belong to Jesus. What are you doing? Why are you not allowed to do it? Why not? Okay, tell me why. Give me the reason. Why? You don't want to work for God? You just said you're an evangelist. What does an evangelist do? Oh, you don't want to do it? Okay. Alright, that's alright. I couldn't force you to do it. Ruth, yeah, come and get yours. You do something for God. Olanike, don't lose your blessings, you know. Olanike is something that made you say what you say. Yeah, take what you want. Now a bit more. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Put your hands together for Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Put your hands together for Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I don't know if I've got enough time to read a scripture. I think I have. And I'm going to read from the book of Acts. Pay attention. See how many evangelists. Okay, Alani, can you read it for me, please? The book of Acts, chapter 9. Pay attention to this, because you're not ordinary no more. You're an evangelist of God. You are the one doing the feeding now. Hang on. Acts 9, 20 verses. No. Let's go to Acts 10. Verses 42 to 43.